Hey there, listeners. Thanks again for tuning into Sin's Workshop. Hope you're having a wonderful day. So today we're going to be talking about How to Survive Your Murder by Danielle Valentine. I have to say this is probably one of my favorite books so far this year. Absolutely freaking loved it. I think Danielle Valentine did a great job incorporating a lot of elements from those classic 90s. I love how I'm saying classic, even though I was born in the 90s. Those 90s slasher films. You know, basically the story opens up, it's Halloween night, you have our main character chatting with her friends about a podcast on the final girl. Like, what does it mean to be a final girl, you know? And she's going to, you know, a Halloween party with her friends. Her sister's making her, and this same night she sees her sister get murdered. Fast forward a year later, right? And she keeps running into a Sidney Prescott lookalike, and I think it's really just an amazing book. I mean, I love those classic 90s movies, the slasher films. I love this whole Scream franchise, and this movie's basically, not movie, this novel was basically like an homage to Scream. Like, let's analyze all those tropes and see if we can survive our own murder. You know, you never split up, you never say I'll be right back, you have to, there are rules, man. And I think it's great. I think it's really playing on that playful aspect of this tropes in order to give this story a really strong foundation, especially because the story does have a time travel element. It is similar to Happy Death Day, but in Happy Death Day, you know, she keeps reliving her death until she finally solves it repeatedly. Again, freaking love that movie. Love the sequel. Loved Freaky. Those three movies and Scream, those are like some of my favorites. But I think Valentine really did incorporate what makes those, you know, Scream and Happy Death Day, what made those two really, really good. She incorporates those elements into her story, and she makes it something fresh, she makes it something new, and honestly, absolutely loved it. I can't stress that enough. You know, I understand that the time travel element, it may not connect with a whole lot of people, but it worked. The way that Valentine structured it worked. You have an angel, right? And she admits she's an angel. She's like, I'm an angel. I'm your guardian angel. I'm sending you back so you can solve your sister's murder. She's like, you think you know everything, but you don't. So, you are kind of on the fence. Like, you're like, okay, is this really an angel? Or is this really, like, a demon? Because her sister's dead, right? But her sister's not dead anymore. She saves her sister. But now more people are dying. Like, a lot more than beforehand. So, it really is such a compelling and great novel. I really loved how it worked. I loved the build. I loved the tension. And I love the unpredictability of it. Yes, it's a slasher novel. And it's so great. Especially because she has to think. You know, Alice is like, okay, I have to be the final girl of the story, but I have to save everyone else. So, what the hell am I supposed to do? And then she really starts analyzing, you know, her own behavior and other people's behavior, and pretty much she doesn't know who to trust, right? There are so many red herrings in the story. And little by little, Valentine is hinting at who the murderer is. I had a couple theories. I did have a couple theories. One of them was right, but I still didn't see it coming. I was just like, what the hell. And I like that. I like when an ending is able to get me by surprise. Because even though all those, you know, hints were there, it's one of those hints just like, but that's too obvious. So it can't be that. And then with all the other red herrings thrown in, Valentine structures a story that really showcases that literally anyone could be the killer. I mean, when you first watch Scream the first time, and I say this every time I watch it, yeah, I know it's Billy Loomis. And there are some Billy Loomis type characters here. I know it's Billy Loomis. But even then, I'm just like, it could be that guy. It could be that guy. Billy Loomis did a great job faking his death, so it can't be Billy Loomis. And I'm like, could be them. Could be them. You don't know. You know, there are lots of opportunity for you as a reader to second guess yourself. And that really showcases, I think, Valentine's gift for storytelling. And I don't know if many of you know this. This is Danielle Vega, or she used to go by Danielle Vega, you know, author of Survive the Night, The Haunted, The Merciless. Freaking loved Survive the Night. That book is one of those that kind of kept me up at night, especially because I read it at night and I'm like, why did I read this? She has a really good knack of keeping the story incredibly engaging. You know, that pacing, again, it's top notch. It's nonstop. It just keeps going and going and going. And it keeps rising and rising and rising along with that tension. And that's what I think works really well for this story, especially because it's a slasher. You know, you don't want it to be predictable. You don't want it to be obvious. Because then that kind of takes out kind of the joy. I mean, on one hand, you're less like, yes, I knew it. And you like that feeling of, yes, I knew it. But you don't want it to be so obvious right from the get-go. And for me, I didn't think it was obvious. There were still too many suspects by the time I got to the end. I had narrowed it down to 2. And I'm like, no, actually, I had narrowed it down to 3 by the time I got to the end. And even then, I couldn't pin it down. I'm like, it's one of these 3 people. It has to be one of these 3 people. So I was a third of the way right. But you don't want the story to be predictable. You want that surprise that's at the end of the story. You like that surprise. I know I did. You know, personally, I really did enjoy that surprise by the end. Especially that the ending was jaw-dropping, and I need a sequel, and I need a sequel right now. I just think it was a fun story. It was fun, and it was energetic, it was entertaining. I absolutely 100% loved it. I cannot stress that enough. It really was just a fabulous series. It really was. I loved it, you know. So, you know, with that in mind, I am going to give this book a 5 out of 5 stars. If you love those 90s slasher films, if you love Scream, if you love Happy Death Day, you're going to love this book, hands down, just like I did. The fact that Alice, our main character, has a Halloween theme song as her ringtone, you hear it. Like, in your head, you hear it, and I think that's great. You can connect to the story. You can get lost in the story. You are invested in what the hell is happening. Who is the murderer? You want to solve it. You know? This isn't, oh, you know who it is. You know? It's a mystery. And it's a horror. And it is a slasher film. And it is great for all those things. So, I'm going to go ahead and give this book 5 out of 5 stars. Freaking amazing. Freaking loved it. Comes out August 30th, 2022. So please pre-order it. read it any way you can. It was amazing. So, again, 5 out of 5 stars. Hope you all continue to support me by liking this podcast, sharing it with all your book-loving friends, and subscribing to it. I hope you all have a great rest of your day, and as always, happy reading.